Hello people,
Welcome to Gurukula.
I am Jai. So today in this video we are going to see the second part of free space path loss model by using Frii's equation. So as usual, if you like the video, do press the like button, or if you don't like the video, press the unlike button. I will consider that as a feedback and I will improve. So without any further delay, let's get into today's topic. In our previous video, we have derived or we have formulated the Frii's free space equation, and the Frii's free space equation is given by the received power PR is equals to PTGTGR times lambda squared over 4 pi d the whole squared into L, where L represents the loss, the system loss. So if you have not seen the formulation of this particular equation, I will give the link on the top right corner. You can check out the first part and then you can resume with this video. So today in this video we will see how to frame a path loss model from the Frii's free space equation. So we know that the Frii's free space equation is given by PR of D. The PR of D stands for the received signal strength will drop down in terms of the distance between the transmitter and then the receiver. And we have seen that this is the Frii's free space equation. So today in this video, we will keep this Frii's free space equation as a base equation, and then we will try to formulate a path loss model. So path loss model for free space propagation, mathematically, free space path loss in general is represented as the ratio between the transmitted power and then the received power. So the transmitted power here in our equation is PT, and the received power here in our equation is PR. So since I already have the Frii's free space equation, I'll try to rewrite the FSPL stands for free space path loss. So the free space path loss is given by the ratio between PT over PR. So I can write this PT by PR from the Frii's free space equation. So I already have PR. If I just pull out this PT from the right hand side, I will get PR divided by PT is equals to GTGR times lambda squared divided by 4 pi d the whole squared. But free space path loss is the ratio between PT by PR. So if I reciprocate this, I will get PT by PR is equals to 4 pi d the whole squared over GTGR times lambda squared. So this is the free space path loss equation. But there is one thing which we have to observe over here is the terms GT and GR are represented either in dBi or dBd. But usually the path loss will be measured on an dB scale. So in order to convert the above equation to dB scale, we will take 10 log on both sides. So taking 10 log on both sides, I will end up with an equation. So 10 log of PT by PR is equals to 10 log of 4 pi d the whole squared over GTGR into lambda squared. So this is what the dB scale of the above equation. So I will slightly rewrite the equation so that this equation will almost look like the Frii's free space equation. I will just reciprocate only this particular term so that I will end up with the equation like this. So this equation looks very similar to Frii's free space equation except the term PT. So this is done only for the mathematical manipulation, and that is the reason why the negative appears in front of minus 10 log. And then further simplifying the equation, when you assume that the GT and GR is equals to 1, then the equation will take the form 10 log of PT by PR is equals to minus 10 log of lambda over 4 pi d the whole squared. Even you can bring the squared over here, and then you can write it as minus 20 log of lambda by 4 d. You can write it in that way as well, but we will go with this equation fine. So the path loss in dB scale is given by minus 10 log of lambda divided by 4 pi d the whole squared. So this equation is what we refer to as Frii's free space path loss model. So when you observe this, when the received power level, the path loss will be directly or inversely proportional to the square of the distance between the transmitter and then the receiver. So this is the final path loss model for Frii's free space equation. But Frii's free space equation comes with certain drawbacks as well. So the drawbacks are, the Frii's free space model is valid predictor only when d is not equals to 0. So when you, this d should not be equal to 0. If this d is equals to 0, then the entire equation becomes infinity. So that is one drawback which we will face in Frii's free space equation. And the second drawback is, we have assumed only the line of sight signal, but in most of the practical situations we will not experience only the line of sight signal. Obviously we will have multipath components as well. So we will come to the second drawback later. First of all, we will address the first drawback, which means what will be the case for d. So in case if free space equation is valid predictor only for d is not equals to 0, where d represents the transmitter receiver separation, then where should I place my receiver? So the entire equation stands valid only if I place my receiver at a particular distance d. So where should I place the antenna? To answer this question, we must go through the fields of an antenna. So when you consider a radiating antenna, the entire antenna region is classified broadly into two types. So one is the near field region and another one is far field region. So the near field region is further classified into two categories or two regions. First one is reactive region and another one is radiative region. So this radiative region is what we sometimes we call it as Fresnel's region. And then second one is far field region, and this far field region is sometimes we call it as Fraunhofer region. So all these regions are calculated by using the expressions like this. So this particular boundary is calculated by the formula 0.62 times square root of L cube divided by lambda, so which will give you this particular boundary, and any region that lies within this particular boundary we call it as reactive region or non-radiative region, where L stands for the largest physical dimension of an antenna. So when you take any antenna, the largest physical dimension should be taken into account, and then lambda stands for the wavelength, and you know the formula for the lambda as well. It is C by F. C stands for the speed of the light, which is a constant, and the frequency that is decided according to the design. So substituting all the values in this expression, you will get a distance over here, and this particular distance, which is less than this particular boundary, we call it as non-radiative or reactive region. And similarly, this boundary is calculated by the formula, so 2L squared divided by lambda. So any region that lies between this region and then this region, we call it as Fresnel region. And then any region that is beyond this particular formula, 2L squared divided by lambda, any region that is beyond 2L squared divided by lambda, we call it as far field region. And in order to call far field region, it is not only enough to satisfy this particular formula, there are two more constraints should also be satisfied. The two conditions should be df. Here df I will consider as an far field distance or Fraunhofer distance. So the Fraunhofer distance should be very very larger than the physical dimension L, and the Fraunhofer distance should be very very greater than the wavelength of the antenna. So satisfying these two conditions in addition to this particular formula, we can call that as an far field region. And then the free space path loss model is valid only if my receiver lies in this far field region. So the received power can be calculated. Here d naught I will consider that as an close in distance. So the received power can be calculated by the expression PR of d naught times d naught by d the whole square. Again, in order to represent this particular function in terms of dB scale, we can take a 10 log for the second term. So I will end up with this equation stating 10 log of PR times D naught plus 20 log of D naught by D. So this is an average received power that I can calculate by using Frii's free space equation model. So that addresses the first one. So the second drawback is this model assumes only an line of sight signal. Of course, yes, we have considered only the line of sight signal, but in practical situations we will have the multipath components as well, which means you will get multiple copies of reflected signal at different time periods as well. So for this we have another model which overcomes this particular drawback. We call that model as two-ray model or ground reflection model. So whereas in that model, you will be considering both line of sight signal and as well as the reflected signal. So which will be more realistic when compared to free space path loss model. So that's the end of this particular video. To sum up, we can see that in this video, we have defined what is free space path loss equation, and then we have defined what are all the antenna regions, and we have found out that the free space path loss model by using Frii's equation is a valid predictor only if the receiving antenna is lying in the far field region. And then we have decided what will be the received power when my antenna is placed at, receiving antenna is placed at the far field region. So that completes the today's video. So the combination of, in the first part of this particular video, we might have formulated how the Frii's equation comes. And then in the later part, which means the second part, we have discussed how to formulate a path loss model by taking Frii's equation as an base equation. So consider subscribing to the channel. See you in the next video. Until then, happy learning.